Good morning. We have already derived the equation for the moment of inertia of a system of particles. Billy, what is that equation?
Flippin' physics.
The moment of inertia of a system of particles equals the sum for every particle in the system, the mass of each particle times the square of r, the distance each particle is from the axis of rotation.
What is moment of inertia?
Rotational inertia.
Rotational inertia is the same thing as moment of inertia?
Yeah, moment of inertia and rotational inertia are two different names for the same thing.
That is annoying.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
What we are doing today is we are going to determine the moment of inertia or rotational inertia of rigid bodies. A rigid body, or a rigid object with shape, is simply an object that does not change shape easily and is larger than a point particle. We are going to treat a rigid body as a large number of small particles, each with a mass delta m sub I, located a distance r sub I from the axis of rotation.
So just the same equation with a delta in front of mass sub I?
Yes, but delta m sub I represents the mass of a small piece of the rigid body rather than a particle in a system of particles.
Sure. And again, we have two names for the same thing. Rigid body and rigid object with shape. This is fun.
Yeah.
Now we take the limit of that equation to increase the number of particles to an infinite number of infinitesimally small particles. The rotational inertia of the object will then be given by the equation. The limit as the mass delta m sub I goes to zero of the sum of delta m sub I times the square of r sub I, the distance each delta m sub I is from the axis of rotation. Class, what is this?
I'm not sure.
It's the definition of an integral.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. Right.
The rotational inertia of a rigid body equals the integral, with respect to mass, of the square of r, the distance each particle dm is from the axis of rotation.
The moment of inertia of a rigid body equals the integral of r squared, the distance each dm is from the axis of rotation with respect to mass. Got it.
All right. Now let's actually determine the rotational inertia of an object. Let's start with a uniform thin hoop. We are going to determine the rotational inertia of this uniform thin hoop of mass capital M and radius capital R as it rotates around an axis which is perpendicular to the plane of the hoop, and that axis goes through the center of the hoop. In other words, if we place the hoop in an XY plane with its center at the origin, the axis of rotation will be directly in the middle of the hoop at the origin and along the Z axis, which is normal to the screen on which you are currently watching this video.
So basically, we are determining how much resistance to angular acceleration a thin roll of tape has if we rotate it about its center.
Yes, that's exactly right.
Screen? What screen?
Yeah. Let's make sure we understand a few terms here. When we talk about a uniform thin hoop, these terms uniform and thin have specific meanings. Uniform means the density of the hoop is constant, and thin means the thickness of the hoop is small enough relative to the radius of the hoop such that the thickness of the hoop is negligible. In other words, this radius which I have given of capital R for the radius of the uniform thin hoop, is that the distance from the axis of rotation to the inside of the uniform thin hoop or to the outside of the uniform thin hoop?
It is actually both.
Oh, right. Nice question. Because the hoop is thin, the thickness of the hoop is considered to be zero, and the radius, capital R, goes to both the inside and outside of the uniform thin hoop.
Exactly. Now, Bobby, how do we take the integral of the square of the distance each particle is from the axis of rotation with respect to mass?
Well, let's add a representative dm to the figure. Actually, every piece of dm of the uniform thin hoop is located the same distance, capital R, from the axis of rotation, So we can replace the variable lowercase r with the constant capital R, the radius of the uniform thin hoop.
And capital R is constant, as you just said, which means we can take it out from under the integral.
And the integral of dm is just capital M, the mass of the whole uniform thin hoop.
So the moment of inertia of a uniform thin hoop about an axis perpendicular to the plane of the hoop and through its center equals the total mass of the hoop times the radius of the hoop squared?
Yes, it is, but why are you phrasing that as a question? What makes you hesitant about that?
Well, that is the same as the moment of inertia of a single particle with a total mass capital M located at a distance capital R from the axis of rotation. Why would those two moments of inertia be the same?
Because every particle of the uniform thin hoop, dm, is located a distance capital R from the axis of rotation, so all the mass of the hoop is located a distance capital R from the axis of rotation. So the rotational inertia of a uniform thin hoop is the same as the rotational inertia of a single particle with a total mass capital M located a distance capital R from the axis of rotation. Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay, yeah, that does make sense.
There are several things I would like you to notice about this. One is that the length of the uniform thin ring in the z direction is not in these calculations. In other words, the moment of inertia of a uniform thin cylinder about the same axis is also equal to the total mass of the cylinder times the radius of the cylinder squared. This again makes sense because all of the mass of the cylinder is still located a distance of the radius of the cylinder away from the axis of rotation. Also, notice a subtle but important difference between the use of lowercase and uppercase letters. The lowercase r and dm refer to variables. Lowercase r is a variable distance between the axis of rotation and the location of dm. Lowercase dm is a mass which could be located anywhere on the hoop, whereas uppercase r and uppercase m refer to constants. Capital R is the constant radius of the hoop. Capital M is the total mass of the hoop. This idea of lowercase letters referring to variables and uppercase letters referring to constants is one which we will continue to see in physics. And lastly, please do not confuse the rotational inertia of a rigid body equation with the equation for the three-dimensional R position center of mass of a rigid body equation. These two equations look very similar to one another. One equation has R as a vector, and the other equation has R squared as a scalar. Because they look so similar, my students sometimes confuse the two equations. So please, be careful to notice they are two completely different equations. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.